Hello and welcome to this demonstration of Find an Apprenticeship. In this video, we will cover how to create a Find an Apprenticeship account, search for apprenticeship vacancies, and how to apply for a vacancy. When you first visit Find an Apprenticeship, you'll be prompted to set up an account. The process of setting up your account is really straightforward. To create an account, you'll need an email address and a UK mobile phone number. We start by creating a Gov1 login. This ensures that all of your personal details are secure. If you already have a Gov1 login, you can skip this part of the process and move on to creating your Find an Apprenticeship account. To start, enter your email address. Please use a sensible email address, as employers will use this email to contact you and follow up on any apprenticeship applications that you submit. After entering your email address, you will be sent a code to verify your details. When you have received the code and entered it, you'll be asked to create a password. The password needs to be a combination of letters and numbers, which is at least 8 characters long. Once you have set up your password, you'll be asked how you would like to receive your login authenticator code. This can be done using a mobile phone or with the use of an authenticator app. Further details on the authenticator app can be found within the blue hyperlink. You'll then be asked to enter your mobile phone number. You'll then receive a code to authenticate your mobile number. You'll be asked to enter the code, which is sent to your mobile phone each time you log into the service. You have now created your Gov1 login and we can move on to setting up your Find an Apprenticeship account. You'll be asked to enter your name and then your date of birth, and then to enter your address. You can do this manually or by using the postcode lookup that's built into the system. You will then be asked to confirm your mobile phone number. Please ensure this is correct, as employers will use this to contact you about any apprenticeship vacancies that you have applied for. The penultimate page in setting up your account asks if you would like to receive email reminders for any applications that you have started but not yet completed. Finally, you are asked to review the details that you have entered. Once you have done this, click Create Your Account and your Find an Apprenticeship account has been created. Now that your account is set up, you can use Find an Apprenticeship to search for apprenticeship vacancies. You can do this by using a keyword or making a location search. Or if you're unsure what you're looking for, you can browse the things that you're interested in. Let's start by looking at the Browse Your Interests section. When selecting Browse Interests, you'll be taken to a list of apprenticeship categories. Simply tick the areas that you're interested in and want to search for. Moving back to the main search page, I'll now demonstrate how to make a search for a specific type of apprenticeship. Enter the type of apprenticeship that you are interested in. You can add a specific location, or you have the option to leave the location blank and view all the vacancies that match your interest across the whole of England. On the Vacancies Found page, you have a number of options to further filter the results. You have the option to add a location if you've not done so already. You can also filter on apprenticeship levels, change the location radius to a wider area, and also have the option to only show disability confident employers within the results. You can also display the vacancies in a map view. This helps to understand where the employers are and where their vacancies are located. You can click the markers on the map to see which vacancy is located where. Having closed the map view, let's now open one of the vacancies that is displayed in my search results. Each apprenticeship vacancy listed on Find an Apprenticeship is set out in a clear and consistent format. You can see the employer's name at the top of the vacancy, and within the summary section of the advert, you can easily see other key information such as an overview of the apprenticeship, the type of training offered, the wage, the working pattern, the number of apprenticeships available, and the expected start date and duration of the apprenticeship. As we move further down the apprenticeship vacancy, you'll see further information on the type of work that the apprenticeship entails and the type of thing that you'll be doing on a day-to-day basis. The employer's full address will be given, and you can use the Check Travel to Work option to help understand where the employer is located and plan how you will get to work on a daily basis. You can change the options of how you plan to get to the employer's premises. You can view the suggested route of how to get there by car, public transport, walking or by cycling. You should use this feature to understand and plan if you're able to travel to the employer's premises and how long it might take you to get there. The vacancy description then provides further information on the training that will be given as part of the apprenticeship. It provides further information on who the training provider is, and by clicking on the course content option, you'll see a full description of what the apprenticeship training entails and what you will learn in your off-the-job training. The vacancy description details any requirements that the employer has requested. This could be certain GCSE or A-level results in a certain subject, or specific skills that the employer requires from their candidates. The next section of the vacancy description gives further details on who the employer is. It's always worth looking at the employer's own website to find out more information about them and what they do. Employers may also list here any other benefits that they offer to their employees, such as a pension scheme or other company discounts. The After This Apprenticeship section provides details on what to expect on completion of your apprenticeship. This may include details on progression opportunities within the company, or potentially detail further learning opportunities, such as progression onto a higher or degree level apprenticeship. There is always contact information towards the end of the vacancy description, should you need to contact the employer or training provider to ask any questions. At the bottom of the page, you have the option to apply for the apprenticeship. At this point, some vacancies will direct you to the employer's own recruitment site. Other apprenticeship vacancies will ask you to complete an application directly through the Find an Apprenticeship site. Let's now look at how to apply through the Find an Apprenticeship site by clicking the Apply for Apprenticeship button. Each apprenticeship that you apply for through the Find an Apprenticeship site will be laid out in the same format. With the first vacancy that you apply for, you'll be asked to enter a number of details. However, any subsequent vacancies that you apply for, these details will automatically be populated. But it is really important to tailor each application to that specific employer's requirements, and it's always worth having a copy of the vacancy description at hand. To start, you are asked to enter the qualifications that you have gained either at school, college or sixth form, or through any other studies that you have completed. If you are currently studying qualifications but have not yet completed them, the option is available to add predicted grades. You can add as many qualifications as you like and add multiple qualification types. Click the Continue button once you are happy with the information that you have entered. The rest of the application form is set out in a similar format to the qualification section. It is important that you complete your application form with as much detail as possible. Employers will review your application, so ensure to include information on your skills, your strengths, any employment history, including volunteering work or any work experience that you've completed, and make your application as strong as possible. Before submitting your application, it is important to review the information that you are about to submit. Check the application for any spelling or grammar mistakes and ask yourself if what you are about to submit is as good as you can possibly make it. The site allows you to save your application and come back to it to submit it at a later date. The Your Application section at the top of the screen allows you to view applications that you have started, applications that you have submitted, and you can also see successful or any unsuccessful applications that you have made. To summarise, you should now be able to create your Find an Apprenticeship account, make a search for apprenticeship vacancies that you are interested in, and submit an application. For other apprenticeship service videos, please visit and subscribe to our DfE SectorComms YouTube channel, where you will find a number of demonstrations and webinar recordings on how to use the apprenticeship service. Thank you for watching, and good luck with your apprenticeship search.